So today marks week 2-ish of working on my largest commission. This is the progress video of it. So I went ahead and started blocking in the colors of the background, foreground, the family and their clothes, and I'm really liking how it's turning out. And I'm one of those artists that gets a little bit too excited and may or may not end up revealing the artwork to the client before it's even done. That's something that I've been working on it, okay? This is something that I've been working on, and fortunately I have held back from sending any more update photos. Let me not lie to y'all. I did send one or two or three update photos because I got really excited. But anywho, Heidi, if you're watching this, oh, this is for my dear friend Heidi. Hi, Heidi. This is just an update video of your commission. I'm loving how it's coming out, and I really hope you love it when it's done. I'm not sure I'm thinking I'll probably have this done by the end of the week. See, what's getting me right now is this is, even though it's the largest commission I've ever done, it's also the smallest, if that makes sense. When it comes to portraiture, I'm used to painting on like 8x10, 9x12, 11x14, essentially anything that involves me painting the proportions of the face in kind of like a larger frame or a larger magnitude, if that makes sense. You done, Spike? Bless you. Sorry, my cat has allergies. So that is part of the challenge, but y'all, your girl loves a challenge, so this has definitely kept me busy. But anywho, each one of us has a season of our life where, for lack of better words, it just may feel tumultuous or overwhelming, or it may feel many other different negative emotions. Maybe you feel like you're not being heard in a certain season, or you're hurt by family pains or betrayal, or you're just going through something, you know? Essentially, what I'm trying to say is, in life, there is going to be trouble. And we all have that season in life where we go through trouble. We all go through trials. One of the ways I escape is running to God, first and foremost. Actually, it's not even one of the ways. That is the way. That is the way. When you're going through hardships, when, or even in times of joy, times of celebration, running to God first, above all else, that is what comforts me. That is something that, at the end of the day, I can confidently tell you guys has changed my life for the better. Like, I'm so glad I came to know who Jesus Christ is and who he was when he was on the earth and who he still is today. And the Lord is my rock. He is my redeemer. He is, though my father and mother reject me, it is God Almighty who takes care of me, who keeps me. And that is a verse that I've been meditating on for the past 2 days now. And I just wanted to say to anyone who's going through any hardships to run after God. And if you feel like you have been running towards God, or you have been praying to him, but you just don't feel heard, trust me when I tell you, he hears you. He tells you that he hears you. He promises you that he hears you. And it may feel like he's distant. It might feel like your prayers aren't being answered, but trust me, I've been there. We've all gone through it, and I can attest to you just based off my own testimony, and actually my testimony not only over the course of the years, but this past week, I was in that situation again where I felt like God wasn't there, where I felt like the Lord wasn't listening. But when I studied Psalm 27, when I truly like meditated on that Psalm of David, it reminded me just that God is my rock, that he is my provider, he is my protector, he is my redeemer, and he is my father and mother when both my father and mother forsake me. The Lord is with you, and if you feel as though your answers aren't being like heard or answered, rest assured that God answers every and all prayers, but that doesn't mean all prayers are going to be met with a yes. I remember someone told me that God always answers prayers, but he gives them one of three answers: yes, no, and not right now. But each answer, with whichever one it is, he answers it in his love. Maybe you're asking for a situation to just be over and done with, but God knows best. He knows that that situation, if he were to just end it in a snap of a finger, with the snap of his fingers, then that would prevent you from growing into the person he has created you to be. Maybe you're asking for a Tesla and God's like, okay, no, because he knows it might make you prideful. Essentially, what I'm saying here is don't give up. And life is hard. We are not promised a comfortable and happy life, but instead we are promised that in the fire, in the trials of this life, we have a God who is with us and who will be with us, who will not abandon us, and who sees us. Anywho, next point. Other than that, though, something else that I do enjoy coming to, something else I wanted to talk about is how, yes, put God first, especially if you're looking for something to escape to, because God, at the end of the day, he is our source of long-lasting, everlasting, permanent joy. Nothing else. That's period. Nothing else. I'm not even joking. Like, guys, trust me on this. I've been there. I have lived a life without God. I'm so glad the Lord brought me back to him. Let me tell you, the Lord is the answer. I'm gonna tell it, like, I'm not playing, like, anywho, sorry. So, actually, no, I'm not sorry. I'm so glad I'm able to just talk about how good God is. God is so amazing. Like, he's so kind. But essentially, another reason why I wanted to make this video is because I found that during that time, which is last week, when I felt overwhelmed, I felt alone, I felt, I don't know what else to say other than I felt rejected. I felt like my own family kind of let me down. Yes, of course I ran to God, but also something that I appreciate is the gift of art that the Lord has given us. Art truly is a gift, not only a gift for us to express love, excitement, and joy and comfort into other people's lives, but to bring beauty in their life. But also, when we create the art itself, it is a gift that God gives us to bring us joy when we create art. Last week, during the whole troubling season I was in and still kind of recovering from, I just decided, you know what, I did not feel at all motivated to paint. I did not want to paint, though I knew that is something that would in the end bring me a little bit of happiness, knowing that I was able to just be creative, and I knew that it would be a great distraction. I just wanted to sulk in my bed. I wanted to be alone. I wanted to grieve. And honestly, we all need that time. Don't get me wrong. There is nothing wrong with taking time to rest up, to grieve, whatever you need to do to process, whatever you need to do, do it. I also decided, you know what? I'm going to paint. I'm just going to focus on doing the next right thing. And one of the next right things for my schedule that week was to work on this commission. When you actively do the next right thing, that feeling of overwhelm, it just vanishes. It goes away. Because it's just, I don't even know how to express it other than knowing and feeling and experiencing the fact that you're on the right path. When you're doing the next right thing and that's all you can do, that just takes away the overwhelm, in my opinion, and using art as a way to do that. So on my list of things on my list of priorities, this commission is definitely number one, because of course I do value my clients and I want to make sure I can create beautiful pieces for them that bring them long lasting comfort. Just the fact that I was able to do that for someone while still struggling with my own things, it makes me praise God even more because of that opportunity. So if you're going through something, if you need a way of escape, honestly, pick up a paintbrush, pick up a pencil, whatever medium you enjoy creating with. Even if you're not like a traditional like fine artist, if you like to play the guitar or write short stories, just be creative. Have a creative outlet. Have a way of escape. One that not only will bear fruits in your own life, but will bear fruit in other people's lives. I remember there's a song that I would listen to on repeat. It's called I Can Only Imagine. And I believe the writer of that song, I remember it was a movie, but I remember he wrote that during a very troubling time. And it, yo, I'm sure if you heard it, you would know it. That is a well-known, like, faith-based song. It's so beautiful. I would listen to it even before I came to Christ. That's how beautiful it was and still is. And I don't know, I just think there really is just so much blessing in creating. There's just so much wonderful fruits in the act of creating, not just of course giving the creation to someone you love or someone who admires your work, but just the act of creating it in times of trouble, being able to still create something beautiful during those times, being able to escape through your artwork, that in and of itself is such a blessing. And it shows how valuable life is, how beautiful and complex and amazing life is. And yeah, those are just my two cents. And I hope you guys enjoyed this little video. And also comment below what you want to see next. Thank you.
Thank you.